Baker Mayfield at the scouting combine when the Browns were trying to decide who to draft number one overall said he was the guy to change the culture in Cleveland. Well, Baker Mayfield has led the Browns to the playoffs and had a chance to answer that age-old question about how he felt about changing the culture in Cleveland.
Well, first, I'd say, you know what, I've had a ton of help along the way. Like I said, there's been a lot of turnover. There's, you know, very few players that are here that have endured the, you know, the not so great times. You know, which is why we mentioned guys like Joel and, like you said, Miles didn't win a game his rookie year, but there's a turning point. And all it takes is you have to weather the storm. You have to be able to take those punches. I have a good buddy. He's the same one I've brought up before that played at St. Ed's. I won't cuss, but he says you have to eat your crap burger. You can insert the other word for it. You have to eat your crap burger before you have a real good burger. And so a lot of people here have weathered the storm, rolled with those punches, and you're seeing the benefits of just staying tough and doing that, facing adversity head on and saying, you know what, we're tired of it, and let's go on to the next one.
And Baker Mayfield talking about helping the Browns back to the playoffs for the first time since 2002. Let's welcome back in Dan Labbe, Browns beat reporter here on cleveland.com. And Dan, you know, weathering the storm is something Baker really did this year as well. It was not a smooth season for him early in the year. He struggled a little bit. And he's played really well the past 8-10 games, probably since the bye week.
You know, really, really going back to that first Pittsburgh game, and he has that Cincinnati game, has to deal with the bad weather. It's been an interesting kind of year for Baker Mayfield, coming off what happened in 2019 and now into 2020, and he's really established himself as a guy that, you know, you're going to look at and say, you don't see a scenario where he's not going to be your starting quarterback next year. You're going to pick up that fifth-year option. You might even start talking extension this offseason, especially depending on how the playoffs go, but you know, having that level of play that he's brought and understanding the offense and just knowing like, okay, this is the guy that's going to be out there every single Sunday for this football team. And we're going to build everything else around that. It just helps stabilize things, especially when you have a coach that really understands how to use him.